down here would complete the most unbelievable comeback in Kansas City history.
Come on, Eddie, you gotta help me, man. It's raining worse in here than it is outside.
Oh, hold on, man. I got $100 on this game. Give it to Marcus. There's Don't give it to the white boy.
You don't feel that, man? It's raining on your head.
Uh-oh, good looking out, man. You know, this time of year, I always keep a spare. Just like being at the game.
Isn't it quite funny, Bob? They just won't leave you alone while you're sitting inside your home.
Baby, I don't want you to go, but after that workout I just gave you, you're gonna need a little rest.
Well, why can't I sleep here?
Our problem ain't sleeping here, it's waking up here. You know, I mean, what Malcolm gonna think?
Why are you so afraid of your friends knowing about our love?
Baby, I'm not afraid. I'm just trying to keep it spicy, you know what I'm saying? Being sneaky makes romance better. Matter of fact, being sneaky makes everything better. You know, it's kind of like that forbidden fruit. It's always better than the unforbidden fruit. It's got worms in it. Rats been nibbling on it.
Oh, Eddie, that's a sensitive man. Oh, keeping a secret keeps it hot. It's like Romeo and Juliet, the world's greatest lovers. Their love was secret, too.
That's what I've been saying, baby. Look here, get thee home, Nicolette.
Oh, but wait a minute, Eddie. In the play, Romeo and Juliet both wind up dead.
There was a play?
What's going on out here? I thought I heard Nicolette's voice.
Oh, no, no, man. That was Loretta. Yeah, she worked at Fell Express.
So what was she doing here at 2:30 in the morning?
Oh, I told her I absolutely positively had to have it tonight.
There's an officer from the bank coming down to the bar today to talk to us about a loan.
A loan? How much does a roof cost?
About $20,000.
$20,000? Malcolm, look, let's rethink this whole situation. Do we really need a roof?
Only when we're home. Man, you hear that? The thunder's shaking the whole building.
Hello.
Tell me, looks like you've outgrown the raincoat, G.
No, Mal. It's just another example of the cruelest words ever uttered by mankind. One size fits all.
What's going on with yourself, big guy?
All my years of school have finally paid off. Today, it's official. The hospital issued me my name tag. Tim Kirkland, male nurse. Ooh, happy hour.
Hey, Mal. Worked this up for you.
What is this?
It's my estimate. And what it'll cost to fix the roof. You said $20,000. Can do it for $175.
The savings of $19,830 is intriguing, Eddie.
But there's no way I'm letting you up on the roof. I'll do it. I always wanted to go up on a roof. You know, for some strange reason when I was growing up, my pops would never let me go up there.
Obviously, your father had some knowledge of structural engineering.
I think that's the guy from the bank. Check it out.
Hey, you must be Mr. Bellamy from Universal Trust. How you doing? Malcolm McGee. This is my partner, Eddie Sherman.
How do you do?
Hey, man, your bank is big in my family, man. My second cousin robbed y'all.
He's quite the comedian, isn't he, sir?
I'm not joking. They got him.
Mr. Bellamy, why are you staring at me?
Actually, I'm sizing you up.
How am I doing?
You got a little breakfast on your chin there.
Well, let's get straight to the point. As you know, my bank holds the note on your building. So whether or not you gentlemen get the $20,000 in refinancing you seek is up to me.
Man, how do you bribe a banker when they already got money?
Are you acquainted with the expression, you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours?
Oh, hell no, man. We don't need the money that bad.
Mr. Bellamy, excuse me, but apparently my partner is not familiar with the expression.
Mr. McGee, I have a daughter recently separated from a wannabe musician. I'm trying to get her life back in order. So you give her a job, I'll give you the loan.
Oh, that kind of scratching. Oh, we can handle that.
Hold up, Eddie. Mr. Bellamy, your daughter can't get a job anyplace else?
Apparently not.
What's wrong with her? Thief, murderer, extortionist, nymphomaniac, just a little freaky dicky.
Actually, she's an arsonist.
I was just getting ready to say that.
The separation wasn't pretty. She burnt down her husband's house. The court has ordered that she won't have to go to jail if she makes full and complete restitution.
That sound like Judge Judy. She got my cousin like that for robbing your bank.
Mr. Bellamy, I'm sorry, but I can't just hire a...
Daddy, are you gonna be much longer? I'm not loving the neighborhood.
She can start tomorrow.
You put the matches up, she can start right now.
I want you to meet your new employer, Malcolm McGee.
How you doing? Is there something wrong?
Don't take this personally, but if I'm going to be working for you, I need to fix myself a stiff drink.
How about we make it $15,000 and we get her a job down in Eddie's garage?
Oh, no, hell no. Hell no, I got flammables down there, man. Look at the bodies on knee honeys.
Ooh, uno momento, wait one minute. Look at that one, boss. You know me, I love a substantial rear end.
Got that, man. Substantial rear end.
That's right, that's right.
You know, Hector, for a brown brother, you sure is black.
Yeah. I thought you knew, bro.
I know now.
That's right.
Yeah. I'm gonna get you red 4x4 pickup.
That's the best one.
Yep. Yeah. Look, do me a favor. Can't tell Malcolm about none of this.
No problemo. Us black men, we gotta stick together, bro.
Hi, Eddie.
Oh, Lord. I say, Camshaft, come over and tell me how much work I gotta do.
I just came by to tell you.
Camshaft.
To tell you that I'm free tonight after midnight.
Never mind, Hector. You're definitely black. CP time. Let's go on, work something out. Look, you can't say midnight around Hector.
Eddie, I know you're not gonna Romeo and Juliet me again. Look, it bothers me that all I am to you is a 2:30 in the morning hit and run.
I am hurt and offended, baby. When did I run?
Hello? Welcome to McGee's. Can I help you?
No, actually, I'm doing pretty well. Hey, I don't recognize you. Are you new?
Name's Brooke. I've been sentenced to work here. Got any matches?
No, I don't, but I can understand why you ain't thrilled about working here. You're obviously far too well-bred and intelligent to be a waitress.
You can tell?
No, not really, but you seem a little disgruntled, and I was gonna order a drink, and I swear you're just gonna put something in it.
You are funny. Are you a regular here?
Regular as they come. I'm Nicolette.
Nice to meet you. Listen, I'm looking for an apartment in the neighborhood, and would you happen to know of any leads?
I know a great lead. Me. I'm looking for a roommate. You want to come upstairs and see my apartment?
Well, does it have a view, hardwood floors, cedar-lined walk-in closets?
No, but it's got a hot plate, a see-through shower curtain, and a three-bladed ceiling fan. But your share of rent is only $250.
Sounds lovely. When can I see it?
Top of the stairs, turn left, apartment A. Just give me a few minutes to tidy up and regrout.
Brooke, listen, I hate to bother you, but there's a guy at table 7 who's waiting on service.
Oh, that doesn't bother me, Malcolm.
Look, I really don't mean to throw a monkey wrench in your first day, but let's break down the word waitress, shall we? You have wait, which means to serve, and then there's stress, meaning get the hell over to table 7 now.
I am not going to serve him. He's got alcohol on his breath.
Brooke, this is a bar. I'd like to see some alcohol on this table.
You are crossing a line, Malcolm. All day long, Brooke do this, Brooke bring me that. And I'm telling you, I can't take much more. You're driving me crazy.
Shh, shh, shh. It's cool. It's all right. Listen, calm down. Tell me, what's wrong here? You were so nice and sweet to everybody else, but you talk to me like dirt. Is there something I'm missing? Because I don't get it. Hey, yo, Brooke. Look, I forgive you for burning down my house, all right? So just come on home, baby. Daddy's gonna give you another chance. Now I get it.
Malcolm, meet my estranged husband, John Blaze.
Good to meet you. Sorry to hear about the house. It's all good. I got a new one. You look familiar. Have we met? I don't think so. I would remember a GQ smooth like yourself.
What are you doing here, John?
I should leave you two kids alone. Good luck. He doesn't have much of a personality, but he is certainly one handsome-looking brother. So where your stuff at? I'm gonna throw it in the car.
Have you lost your mind? I'm not going anywhere with you.
Oh, well, you still tripping about me in a hot tub with Kim and Diane?
Oh, I'm way past tripping, John.
I'm telling you, baby, that was business.
Oh, and what about Mindy, Cindy, and Mei Ling? Were they business, too?
No, they was a business gift. But, baby, I'm over all that now.
And I'm over you. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to look at a new apartment. Do us both a favor. Don't come back.
I won't, but you will. Yo, you done with that? You are now.
I hate to be the one to break the news to you, but you've been hijacked. I got the number of the road gang. Please turn the glare down. You're blinding me, bro. Look, man, I'm gonna go up on the roof and fix it. If that's cool with you.
I don't give a damn what you do.
Never seen him so sensitive about a haircut.
Not bad. I see possibilities. Is it quiet?
Quiet? Oh, it's the quietest. Like a cemetery. No noisy neighbors, no traffic. Except on Tuesday mornings when the garbage truck comes and I have to yell out the window, "Damn it, don't you know people are sleeping?" But outside of that, nothing but quiet, quiet, quiet. Oh, in fact, I have to say, this is the quietest.
Nicolette, it's not quiet anymore.
Oh, I'm sorry. If I seem a little nervous, it's because I'm thinking about that guy I couldn't tell you about. Brooke, I don't know if I'm meant to be with him or not. It's so confusing. I just wish the good Lord would give me a sign. Oh! Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah. Guess my tool belt was a little heavier than I estimated. Look, you ladies gonna have to do me a favor. Don't tell Malcolm I fell through the roof.
Fine, we'll just tell him it's raining men.
Hallelujah.
Trust me, he'll never notice. He ain't that observant.
What the hell's going on in here? Is that the sun?
Oh, Mal, don't worry. I got it all covered, man. You know what I'm saying? We'll just put some plastic over the top of it, call it a sunroof, and tack extra on the rent.
Eddie, I specifically and emphatically told you not to go up on the roof.
Now, you was emphatic, but what you said was you didn't give a damn what I fixed.
Now, hold up. I never said that.
Yes, you did 15 minutes ago on the bar. And how the hell did you grow your hair back so fast?
Are they always like this?
No, sometimes they swear.
Look, Mama, you said gone and fix it. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Sometimes stories have surprise endings.
What are you doing here?
I just came to take you back.
Listen to me carefully. I am not interested in you. You're a narcissist, an egomaniac, and I regret the day I ever met you.
So you're not coming back with me?
Not if you were the last man on Earth and the salvation of our species depended on it.
So just to be clear, you're not coming back with me? Look, Blaze, why don't you just give it up, man? I mean, it's obvious the lady's not interested. You should just go home, G. You say something to me? Well, evidently I did, but I don't see any reason to get physical. Oh, so you scared?
Look, that's it. Tired of this. About time I stood up for my boy.
So what you gonna do?
I just did it. I stood up. Go on, whoop him, man. Whoop him.
Hey, come over here. See, Blaze? See, it's two of us and it's one of you. And my partner here is a Taekwondo master. Show me stuff. See, you see that? And also, he's got 6 trophies.
Hey, man. I bought them trophies. Oh, I like to pose as the head, man. You know what I'm saying? I got a hockey one coming, too.
Well, Blaze, listen, give me a minute to rethink my position here. Instead of thinking, you need to be praying, G, because only a miracle is going to keep me from busting you up. Whoa!
Whew. You all right, Tim? Damn, it's like a house fell on him.
I knew I shouldn't have had that last cookie.
Tim, I told you not to go up on the roof. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. But I'm a little worried about the bald-headed man underneath me.
Is he dead? Because that's not something I want in my apartment.
Oh. Yeah, I'm sorry. I lose, Brooke, all right? But I want you to know I still love you.
Brooke, I think you need to listen to this man. I believe he really loves you. Look at him. And you obviously care about him. You don't just set a 5-alarm fire on somebody's house unless there's passion there.
Well, I guess it would be a waste of a perfectly good tattoo. Mama's little 8-ball.
We'll make it work out this time, baby. I promise.
No, I can't. I mean, I have a new life, a new job. And what will the bar do without me?
Brooke, don't worry. Somehow we'll manage.
I'll never forget any of you. Malcolm, you know where to forward my check.
Lucky he left when he did, man. He's getting ready to bust him up. You know what I'm saying? 8-ball.
That's right. Well, you know what? The good thing is, all of our problems are over with.
That's right.
Eddie. It's almost midnight.
What's that all about?
She got a new Timex, man. She been walking around bragging all day on how she know what time it is. Ooh, look at time flying. Yeah, get to bed, man.
Wait. Hold up now. Do you really think I'm that dumb?
No, it ain't what you think. Me and her? Never. Not on this planet. Not on any planet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know what you two are going to do. You guys are going upstairs. You're going to lock the door. And you two are going to take another shot at fixing that roof, huh?
You got me, man. All right, I'm sorry, man. You know what I'm saying? It was her idea, though. Don't you worry about it, though. I'm not going to let her back on that roof. You know what I'm saying? I don't care if I have to pin her down on the ground till she's hollering. I'm not letting her back on that roof. See ya. Come on, Marcus. You know OJ won.
Damn, you look like Thea with no hair.
I'm looking for a roommate. You want to come upstairs and see my apartment? Is that a yes?
Hey, man.